What is Somogyi's effect and dawn phenomena? How many of you want to become endocrinologists? Endocrinology and neurology, remember doctor, among the DM super specializations, they are evergreen kind of a branches where you can relish in that. Let us talk about Somogyi. What is Somogyi basically? Early morning, 6 o'clock, when you check the blood sugar of a patient receiving insulin in type 1 diabetes, he has got a very high sugar. What is the reason for this high sugar? Though you are giving insulin, high sugar is happening. What is the reason for that? There are two schools of thought. It is the yesterday night's insulin, which has led to development of hypoglycemia by the time early morning 2 o'clock. And in turn, epinephrine and all this glucagon and other hormones have taken up, and that led to a rebound hyperglycemia. So how do you treat Somogyi phenomena? You try to titrate such that insulin will not lead to a severe hypoglycemia at 2 a.m. So it is all because of the insulin's effect. But Somogyi phenomena is seen in type 1, not in type 2 diabetes, which you should be very sure about. Then I leave all that literature for you to quickly review, because you are not in a mood to learn now. You are in a mood to know how your other classmates did wrongs. How many of them have gone wrong? Because when you sit for a discussion to write paper, every fellow will say his answer is only right. So you have to choose some master to say that, even master is also wrong sometimes, many times. So that he will tell how he is wrong. So that's the only difference. Now let's go to the next question. What is bitemporal diameter? Bitemporal is basically, biparietal is 9.5. Bitemporal is 8 centimeters. Bimastoid is 7.5 centimeters is what need to be remembered. Glasgow Coma Scale include eye-opening, verbal response and motor response. And what is the minimum score? 3 is the minimum score. You all agree with me. So how many out of the 6 questions you are going to do? Are there any chances of going wrong? No way. You should get 6 out of 6 out of this. There is no surprise in this. Right? You all agree with me. Now there are level C topics. What is the meaning of level C? How many questions came in the past? Around 15 to 20 questions came in past 30 years. There are 26 topics. 26 questions came from the level C topics. I am quite sure any serious student will definitely answer 26, may at least 23, 20. He can easily answer correctly. Let us see what happened. If there is a central placenta previa with hemorrhage, what do you want to do? Nothing you need to do. Elective cesarean section is the only option. Now my question to you is there any type of placenta previa where you can still go for a trial labor? Type 2 anterior will be there, na? There you can try the trial labor. But in central placenta previa, there is no role for the trial labor. You have to go ahead with, especially when there is a hemorrhage, you have to go ahead with the cesarean section is considered to be the method of choice. What is sclerosis and glomus jugular? Regularly questions come. Glomus jugular lead to development of a typical flamingo. It should be otosclerosis. Okay, not glomus jugular. Sorry for the explanation. I think our guys' explanations we will prepare according to our choice. So the flamingo pink is typically seen with the otosclerosis. A small correction in this. Now, what is the most common type of eclampsia? It is basically intrapartum. It can occur even postpartum. But 80% of eclamptic seizures are basically intrapartum is what need to be remembered. For endometriosis, how do you evaluate? Laparoscopy will show you the classical appearances of the endometriosis, like what you are able to see here. What is the typical appearance of the uterosacral ligaments you will see in endometriosis? Powder, burnt powder appearance. Chocolates is etc., etc. We are ready to attack any question on endometriosis, right? Now, peripheral retinal neovascularization, where does it occur? Anything that lead to ischemia to retina will promote neovascularization. So that is the reason we see it with CML, sickle cell anemia, retinopathy of prematurity, but not in cocaine syndrome. What do you see in cocaine syndrome, doctor? Retinal degeneration is what you typically come across in cocaine syndrome. This is a fundamental question. What are the two most hot topics in ophthalmology which made us to pass ophthalmology exam? Glaucoma, cataract. Without that there will be no paper. There are two questions on cataract, right? Mature, uncomplicated cataract. What do you find? This is a very tricky question. I am quite sure you have a great chance of doing wrongs. Because, but after coming out of exam, we will try to feel, array, I would have not done that wrong, right? Now the question is, if it is a mature cataract, will the vision will be totally gone? How will be the vision? We should remember four important things about mature cataract. Entire cortex become opaque. Vision is just reduced to perception of light. Iris shadow is not seen and lens is pearly white in appearance. So if you look at the cataract, we have different types of stages. Lamellar separation, incipient cataract, immature cataract, incumbent cataract, mature cataract, hypermature cataract, etc., etc. is what you should be very sure about. So that is the reason what becomes the answer for this question. Anterior chamber will be normal, it is pearly white and there is no lens shadow of the iris, but absent light perception is not the story. What you find is it remains very little to counting the finger stage is what I like to underscore to all of you. But what would have been the most common wrong answer for this question? Can you guess? About anterior chamber, a good number of students will be tempted to basically put the answer. No regrets. Now, which apoprotein is there in LDL is the question. So what is our every Sunday session, what is that we emphasize? Without a question on hyperlipoproteinemia, if there is a paper, we will stop giving coaching. So, because the purpose of coaching is to make the preparation simpler. Because examiner had been seeing, the coach had been seeing the entrances past 10 years. If something suddenly changed, it means probably should not happen. Now let's talk. It is the ApoB100, which is the predominant type of apolipoprotein in the bad cholesterol of the LDL is what need to be basically remembered. Ring pessary is used in all except. This is a good question where you try to use guess, but there is a scope to miss. What is the most common wrong answer for this question? Okay. Stress incontinence, how many of you have placed it as an answer? Yes, that is a potential wrong answer to the regret. I'll tell you what it is. Stress incontinence, vaginal vault prolapse, cystocele, enterocele, rectocele, uterine prolapse, preoperative preparation. Now let us look at the other options. Patient unfit for surgery, of prolapse we'll try to put a pessary, agreed. Issue is between pregnancy puerperium. But we all know that we place a pessary in the early part of the pregnancy if there is any incompetence of the cervix. That's all what we read. Only thing is puerperium. I spoke to three of my colleague obstetricians. They said, yeah, but still puerperium also doesn't stand as a contraindication in our opinion as such. So that's the reason I still put puerperium as a potential answer. What is Moskowitz operation? So finally there are two questions on prolapse. Prolapse is a favorite topic of the examiner. Many times we all agreed on that. So it is a repair of enterocele which is called as the Moskowitz operation. Generally examiner's tendency is to ask about Sirotkar everything. Suddenly this time he got a Russian vodka feeling. That chalo, Sirotkar sab log ko malum hai. Khanna sling also everybody knows. We'll put some what you, Leo Tolstoy kind of an operation like Moskowitz, etc. Now, continuous fixed traction, this is a traction, very, very, very dirty question, in the sense that orthopedics may, to know fractures itself is a big deal, MBBS level may. That to screws, nuts, bolts, dynamic traction, fixed traction, skeletal traction, skin traction, my God. But we discussed it in our, I finished my homework as a teacher. We discussed in our regular classes about nuts, screws, bolts is a topic. Around 2.5 hours of long discussion we had about different kinds. So two questions are rewarding out of that. Good. So actually these sessions are a training for teacher also. The teacher will next year when he trains students, he must know where to really emphasize and which is rewarding. So there is, doctor, please remember, fixed traction, balanced traction. Balance ka matlab kya hota hai? You'll be applying a tension to an apparatus which remains constant of the length, that's called balanced traction. So this is an example of a balanced suspension skeletal traction with a Thomas leg splint. Then this is an example of a Thomas splint which can also be used as a fixed skeletal traction also. So I leave all this literature for you to review. One of the options was Bond's frame. The Bond frame is a cradle for the limb, but a disadvantage is that the position of the pulleys cannot be altered and the size of the splint does not fit the limb. So these are all the limitations of the bronze splint. So it is a continuous fixed traction can be a Thomas splint is what need to be remembered. Then what are, you have any disagreement on this? We can debate, not an issue. We did homework about the answer. Then next question is, which is not a skin traction, rather skeletal? What is confusion about Dunlop? Dunlop tires? Dunlop pillows? Dunlop mattress? Dunlop has a skin traction and also has Dunlop skeletal traction. So I was talking to my orthopedic classmate when I was in Gandhi Medical College. He was a stretcher mate in anatomy. Suddenly what this Dunlop has hung on your mind. I told I can't be a simple MD general medicine. I have to read gynecology, everything for our students' sake. So first tell me what is this Dunlop. So he confirmed that there are two types of Dunlops. And in addition he actually added, there is also Dunlop tire, Dunlop mattress, so many things. If you have any doubts, please call me back. So Dunlop is basically a skeletal, but Roussel's, Bucks, Briant, they're all definitely skin tractions. There is no doubt about it is what need to be. This is an example of a Bucks extension traction. Is it a skin or a skeletal traction, doctor? At least by looks, we can call it as a skin traction. Then Dunlop, this is an example of a Dunlop skeletal traction, basically. Then this is an example of a Dunlop skin traction, basically. Then this is a Briant's traction, which is once more a skin traction. So these are all the various stories.